They told you that you couldn't do it cause you washed up. Ain't like them bad girls said you should get your sauce up. But I got this plan and you might not understand. I'ma go hard as I can and I'm gonna be the boss of it. Just watch me do this, put no limits, only swag on it. Walk right up to the front where I belong and brag on it. Go to the top, I'ma give it all I got. Might take a lot, but we ain't gonna ever stop.
What's going on, family? How are you? How are you? Welcome back to the Purpose Pusher Podcast. And I am your host, Zavidi Morgan, a.k.a. the Purpose Pusher, a.k.a. Lady CEO, y'all. And thank you for tuning in right here on Talk of the Street Entertainment Network, okay? Purpose Pusher Ministries. Today, I have a word, all right? You know, collective family, I don't know how long you have actually been here with me. Or where you actually have followed me here from. But if you don't know, I want to inform you that this ministry and everything else that I am head of is divinely orchestrated by God. It is moved by God. The color is chosen with the advice of God, the should it everything you can think of when you come to thinking about you know, creating something or building something, the aspects, the elements that go into creating a thing, right, is co-produced by God in my life. But this ministry is something special. This ministry is like the baby. This ministry is, I said, God, have your way. I've been so busy all day long. Do you understand me? I was just somewhere before I came back into the studio. And I'm okay, because you better speak it into existence. Y'all know what's going on here, okay? And so before I came back, and I was out and about, and I was headed home, okay? And my alarm went off and said, Street Talk of the Week. Now, for the newcomers here on the Purpose Pusher Podcast, here on Talk of the Street Entertainment Radio, the Street Talk of the Week used to be the Tuesday night show featured on Talk of the Street Entertainment Network, the network, right? What happened is the Purpose Pusher Podcast took its place, but my phones and my calendar didn't get the memo, obviously, okay? So, but all in all, this was the Holy Spirit prompting me, because, baby, when I said I was on my way home, I was on my way home. I was done. I'm finished. Finito. Out of here. What do you mean? Yesterday was Valentine's Day, okay? Me and the husband kicked it yesterday evening. If you know, you know. And, you know, I had a ball. And so this morning, I had to mess around and go to a court appointment because of some guy that broke into my car last summer. And I'm trying to, it's just, and he's not even there. So I'm there, he's not there. He's been issued a capias. And it's, I mean, I had a day. And then I had a client. The day was profitable. I'm not complaining. Let's understand something here, family. I'm not complaining, okay? But I'm just telling you my day. Can I vent to you? Can I vent to you? In my Mooney Long voice. But no, honestly, so I was on my way home. You feel me? And it wasn't for the Holy Spirit in that calendar, because I have not received that notification in a long time. So I know it was nothing but the Holy Spirit. So yeah, that's my story of being here today and how God is going to orchestrate. Because, honey, the point is, about 10 minutes before I hit record on everything, baby, I'm like, Lord God, now you know, hands up, you already know. Listen, if you know, you know. Lord God, you already know. The Purpose Pusher Podcast belongs to you. Don't I don't even know. You can please endow me. Please, because God, I don't know. I have nothing written. My books and everything is at home, but I know if I go home, it's going to be so much more time. Let me just handle this, get this out the way, and go home and then handle home and everything. Well, you know, so I'm like, I'm leveling with myself. I'm leveling with God. And he obviously, God has it figured out because I'm here and I'm not nervous about anything. I'm just being led. In the spirit, and I thank you, family, for being here. Welcome again to the Purpose Pusher Podcast. If you're new here, welcome, 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 family. Make sure that you share this with somebody who you know may be in need, and share it anyway because you may not know because it ain't your business. You understand? But let's get into it. So this is episode 2, actually. And last week, it was just basically an intro. I was kind of giving you guys the scoop on, you know, the Purpose Pusher Podcast, a little bit of background, and a little bit of a spiritual background on the Purpose Pusher Podcast. As you all may remember, or this may be your first time hearing, I grew up as a Christian. Hallelujah. Yes, 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 Lord. With the title, really, you know, within the religion. Recently, in the last past 10 years, I have stripped myself of the title, and I belong to God, okay? It doesn't need a title. I'm spiritual and holy. And so that has opened me up to so many different, you know, epiphanies in life and spiritual awakenings. I have a higher spiritual consciousness because I let go of those titles and I just stepped into it and was like, God, listen, I'm gonna call you God. I am a child of God, and whatever it is you want to take me into so I can better understand what this energy is, just lead me. And that's what happened. And so you know, I'm come to find out, listen, Christian is not necessarily didn't necessarily start out as a religious title, okay? It's what a group of people call themselves who follow Jesus Christ. You understand me? Just like you from Virginia. Well, Virginians. You understand what I'm saying? So, you know, and that's a whole nother story for a whole nother day. Make sure you tune in to Talk of the Street Entertainment Network on Thursday nights for Bible Study in the Hood. Right now, it's running airing reruns, but in the fall, there are going to be some new episodes happening, but we have reruns of Bible study that get deeper into spirituality and religion and terminology in that way. So I wanted to let the newcomers know that about Zavi D, but let's get into it. So we are here to talk about breaking these generational curses, all right, breaking these toxic chains, so we can get to building generational wealth. Because it's nothing more in the 3D that the enemy wants from you than your mind. Okay, the enemy, they said the devil come to steal, kill, and destroy. Absolutely right. But here's the thing, here's the key. The devil doesn't want your material things. The devil don't want your money. The devil don't want your husband. The devil don't want your children. The devil don't want your business. The devil wants your mind. Because if the enemy can get into your mind and dismantle your thought processes, your belief processes, your perspective, it got you. It got you. So generational curses, you know, stimulate from thought processes. We respond in different situations in life based off of our experiences in life. And unfortunately, we could reach a place where we respond to situations with trauma responses. And trauma responses are responses we have cultivated based on the negative experiences we have had in life. And if we don't deal with those negative experiences from our childhood, and even in adulthood, they will control our outcome in our life situation. Thus, we will have, you know, the character flaws where we procrastinate in life. We self-doubt ourselves. We have insecurities. You know, all of those negative nasties. I call them deficiencies in the book, and you can check it out. The book is on Amazon. You can also find it in the link below, in the description box, profiting your purpose. And dealing is the first step in the true healing process. In my book, I give an example of unlearning the things that we have learned along the years, such as you'll get over it. Oh, just it'll don't worry about it. Don't think about it. It'll go away. You know, when it comes in terms of dealing with the situations that have happened in our life, that particular concept of dealing with the things that has happened to us in our life is one of the things I talk about, you know, that we need to unlearn. We desperately need to unlearn this concept, because what it does is it gives us the opportunity to, the phrase is, scoop it under the rug, right? Follow me in this visualization. It gives us the opportunity to scoop it under the rug. Just scoop it under the rug. Don't think about it. Don't talk about it. Don't do it. Just scoop it. Move it. But eventually, the more you scoop under that rug, the bigger the hump, the bigger the bump, the bigger the evidence of the dirt accumulating under this rug. And every so often, the sprinkles come, baby. The icing on the cake come. Okay, you have a situation that come to trigger you, okay, and it fires off the bomb, okay, that you've created for yourself. All right, now let me go back to the rug. You scoop it under the rug. You end up being triggered, and you trip over the hump. That's what happens, cause you done scooped it under the rug, and you've been fortunate enough to get back up again, because you're listening to me today, or you're watching me today, so you've been fortunate to get back up again. You know, we trip, we fall, and some of us, we get back up again. Cool, all right? But when the cycle comes around again and nothing has changed but the cycle coming around again, if you haven't learned the lesson, right? If you haven't gotten the message from the mess the first time, you're going to find yourself running right back into the same wall. So to eliminate all of that, I said, God, holler at me, because I've been through some things. I said, how am I going to grow through these situations that I have in my life? The childhood trauma I've experienced in my life, my adult trauma that I got back there in the closet, God. I said, listen, I need a word or two, because evidently the things that I've been seeing out here in the world, you know, the things that the people have came and taught me some very valuable lessons, but they're just not, it's not enough. It ain't enough, fool, you know. So it's like, Lord, what do I do at this point? I'm giving it all to you because I'm sick of myself. I thought I had it all figured out. I done shot from the hip. Thank you for carrying me this far, for your grace and mercy, because lo and behold, been in business for 10 years and I shot from the hip the first five. I don't listen. I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing. I just know I want to do it. You understand me? And God seen me through that. So I seen that part. God seen me through being a single mom. You know, God seen me through not being able to complete college. God didn't see me through, you know, the adversities I faced with my mama, me and my brother growing up. It seen me through so much. And so I'm sick of myself, and can't nobody else around me help me. Everybody think I'm crazy because I'm elevating in spirituality. And if you know what that's like, you know, you can't say certain things about, you know, God and the Holy Spirit in a certain environment, because people be like, oh Lord, oh, they probably got the Holy Ghost or something. I don't know. You know, and so when you're young and in spirituality, you're kind of, it makes you, thank you, Holy Spirit, it makes you embarrassed. It embarrasses you. It's like, oh, well, I don't want to, yeah, you got yacht. Let me get button my, Lord, I don't want to get the Holy Ghost in here. But you know, it was a point in time where I became sick of myself. So in today's time, you know, I said, God, it took me 2 years to birth the book. I labored it for 2 years because I was like, I'm scared. Me? You want me to tell people this information? You sure? And so I had to grow through that part. But here we are today, and God said no more. Here go the juice. And for anybody of the 144 plus songs that are here to find out, how can I better navigate through my spiritual journey here in my life and career? What can I do? I'm sick of myself. I know I got some things going on. I got some trauma, childhood trauma, adult trauma. I'm trying to release that. I know it's put me in a position where I've been stagnated. I have, you know, I've ruined my relationships. You know, I need to get this stuff up off of me. Seeing a therapist that really don't, you know, we're not, because it takes a like-spirited individual. And sometimes these people who have these titles aren't like-spirited. You understand me? And it ain't no love lost. It's not that they don't know what they know, but sometimes it just takes the accountability in the body of Christ to get you right. You know that sometimes it's unspoken energy. Sometimes you just need somebody to feel where you've been coming from. Sometimes you have been a little raggedy in your life, and that everything that has happened to you has been on an account of someone else. Maybe you got a few things to do with some of that stuff somewhere up in your life, and you need somebody to understand that, yeah, I've been a little raggedy, but today I'm trying to get my stuff together. Can you help me? Can you feel where I'm, can you pick, my sister-in-law said, she said, are you picking up what I'm putting down? Yes, honey. Okay, baby. Like, that's what it takes. So profiting your purpose. Profiting your purpose gives you all that you need on that, baby. You can find that on Amazon.com or one of the links below. But the dealing process, that's where you find, that's where you get the evidence. That's where you sit and you have these conversations with yourself or with the individuals you need to. You face these situations, those traumas. You face them head on. And you have to be truthful with yourself. Truthful. And this truth also teaches you compassion. It also teaches you how to understand another person's position, not agreeing. That's another thing. Let's be clear here. Understanding and agreeing are two totally different things. Ain't nobody ever told you. I just taught you something. Learn it. Two totally different things. Okay? So we have to put ourselves in a situation where compassion teaches us to understand where that person may have been at to cause us the pain that they've caused us. It's not that you agree. It's not that you're saying that they're right. It's that you have an understanding of what that mindset could have been like. You know what it is for them. And we also have to get ourselves to a point in this dealing phase where even if you have not been able to hear I'm sorry. I know that stung somebody right there. Because sometimes the person is not going to be able to or are going to be around, may not be around to tell you they are sorry. But as long as you allow that situation to have that little bit of power over you, that's a little bit of power that's causing you a whole lot of problem. And you need to deal with it. Deal with it. You have to feel it energetically. You have to feel it energetically. You have to release it energetically. And compassion helps you do that if that's going to be your situation. If you have to move on without hearing the person verbally say, I'm sorry. But you have to put yourself in a situation to see the situations first. And if it, like I said a few minutes ago, if it doesn't have anything to do with someone else, if you put yourself in a situation, this is more likely late teens, you know, when we start to get ourselves, we start to smelling ourselves, like the old people say, and our young adulthood traumas where we find ourselves in relationships and trying to hold on to maybe, you know, childhood friendships or what have you, different scenarios, but you follow me, you know, if you need some information or you know, you want some one-on-one, you know, for your particular, traumas and things that you want to break through on, just hit me up on my DMs, wherever you're watching this at, hit me up wherever messages are being, you know, are able to be transferred. But, you know, so sometimes you have to acknowledge when you've put yourself in situations that have caused you to get that infliction, and that still doesn't make it right. Okay, let's be clear on that. If that's your situation, that still don't make it right, but you have to acknowledge that, okay? And all of that dealing stuff, all of that being real stuff, all of that facing and gaining compassion and you know, opening up Pandora's box, some people may call it, it's beneficial in the end goal because it influences your manifestation process 200%. 200%. Your awareness, your ability to understand another person's position, your ability to be honest and within yourself, that's integrity. Your ability to, in your spirit, be strong enough and honorable enough to say, okay, I messed up. Here was my part in this. Okay, so how can I fix this? Check me, boo. This is what you're telling God. This is what you're telling the universe. You're like, check me, boo, because I want to get it right. Check me, boo. And that shows so much gratitude because you want to live righteously. You want to be in alignment. You want to live in divine flow. This is what you're saying. You're insinuating, you're alluding that this is what you want. And so it quickens the manifestation process in your life. You will be able to think it and it happens. I'm telling you, right now, all of these things are a process, but it takes steps. And unfortunately, in some of our lives, individuals have not given us the game like I'm telling you right now about life. And how you become a master teacher, how you begin to strengthen your purpose, how you begin to, you know, walk in your purpose passionately, because you got to have the fire, baby. It takes all of the elements. It is perfect alignment. When you are God's chosen one, you think you're going to just have a good body and it's done. No, baby, you got to have a good mind, good emotions. Your emotions have to be balanced, baby. Your spiritual, you got to be in alignment, honey. You listen, this is a holistic thing for us. Okay. This is a holistic thing for us. You want to say, why is it so hard for you? Because it is hard for you. You're a chosen one. You're chosen. And without challenges in your life, how are you going to gain the wisdom? How are you going to, if you never pick up a weight, you can be as slim as you want to, but how are you going to be strong? How are you going to challenge your endurance if you never picked up a weight? It takes a little pressure to build a diamond, baby. This whole lifestyle and how it operates is science. Science and spirituality is the orchestration of life. It's the people who creates the law and put all that statue on it, that man-made stuff on it. And it's up to you to start to get away from it, because we're born into it. But it's up to you to start seeking yourself. It's up to your peers. It's up to your family around you to start guiding you and molding you and pushing you in the direction that will benefit you. Not what they want you to be, but what it is you were created to be. You know, in a lot of ancestral tribes, you know, a lot of native tribes, the names of the children detail their future. It's like a prophecy. It's like a prophecy. If you haven't, I challenge you tonight. Here's your first assignment. This might be your only one. I don't know. I told you this. God is doing this. This is God's thing here. I don't know. Okay. But your assignment tonight is to research what your name means spiritually. Everything you do from here on out, whether it's researching a number that comes to you often, and we're going to get there later on in another episode. Okay. I call them angel numbers. Because the universe speaks to us through animals. The universe speaks through us through every element we can see, every living thing. If you just listen, and you have to be in synchronicity with that. You got to be free from a lot of these worldly things, a lot of the negative weight that holds you down to get into that. But I digress, honey, because it makes me excited to do that. When we start dwelling in the whole, honey. But so let's get to this. Let's get past this. So anyway, the assignment for tonight is this. I want you to research the spiritual meaning of your name, okay? And if you have already, let me know about it. Drop it in the comments below, wherever you're watching, tuning in to this episode at. Let me know what it means, okay? Because I'm excited. I'm excited to find out. Jeez, Lord God, okay? Okay, Lord. All right. I know, like I said, I never know. I don't know. Okay, God, Well, for anybody that is in prayer, I'm in need of prayer tonight. Holy Spirit is moving me to say a prayer. For anyone who may be watching and you may be in prayer for whatever it is, I don't need to know your business, but if you want it to be personal, if you want me to put the swag on and make sure you hit me up, so I can be in agreement with you. But right now, the Holy Spirit has just guided me to say a general prayer. So, Universal Life Force Energy, a.k.a. God, I just want to thank you for the opportunity for us to come together, Lord God. I want to thank you for anybody who may be touched by this message, Father God. Deliver what it is you need to deliver to whoever you need to deliver it to through me. I am a willing vessel, Father God, and I ask that you, I touch and agree with anybody who may be asking for something in particular here, Father God. And if it is in your will, Father God, if it is a part of their inheritance, Father God, if it will benefit them positively, Lord God, I ask that you release it right now in the name of Jesus and every other prophet that has graced the earth, Lord, in your name. And I just want to say thank you. Amen. And if it's not their time to operate within whatever it is they asking for, God, I ask that you do give them the hints or the guidance to find out what they need to do to be responsible enough to carry the blessing they asking for. Again, Lord God, I just want to say thank you. Amen. Ashe. Listen, okay? Listen. All right, y'all. So, I wanted to make one announcement that I thought was really, really dope. I know sometimes the chosen ones, we don't always get the blessing. Like, I didn't get a PPP loan. I ain't get no extra food stamps. Everybody was getting. I ain't get none of this free money that was going around out here, y'all. All the discounts. But I ran across this program. Metro PCS is actually a part of this program. So if you have the phone system, Metro PCS, or in connection with Metro PCS, it used to be Intellos a long time ago. They are also connected to T-Mobile and whatever. You should check whoever your phone provider is. You can get possibly $30 off of your bill. So this is called an Affordable Connectivity Program, ACP program, and you can find out more about it at Metro. It's metro-tmo.com. That's metro-tmo.com/AC(P)Paul. I'm gonna repeat that. metro-tmo.com/AC(P)Paul. Go ahead and check that out and see if you can benefit from that program. If you want me all in your business, then let me know how that worked out for you as well. Okay? Well, that's all I have for you today on the Purpose Pusher podcast. Okay? I let God have his way. If you have a specific prayer request or anything that you would like for me to meet with you about on a one-on-one basis, you can definitely check the link in the bio section and description section anywhere. If you are interested in starting a faith-based business, something that you feel purpose to do, I am the one for you. Make sure you hit me up. Yes, description. It's all up in the description box. What else do we have here, Lord? If you are an established business owner and you need some support in your administrative department, specifically human resources, make sure you hit me up. All of the information is in the description box below. I thank you guys once again, family, for tuning in to the Purpose Pusher podcast right here on Talk of the Street Entertainment Network, y'all. I love you. Good night.
K-Classic.
Told you that you couldn't do it cause you washed up. Ain't like them bad girls said you should get your sauce up. But I got this plan and you might not understand. I'ma go hard as I can and I'm gon' be the boss of it. And just watch me do this, put no limits, only swag on.